Hey folks, Dave here, and I am back from Hollywood from a Machinima livestream and ready to get back to work on my Minutemen battle train here at Bedford Station in Fallout 4. This is, of course, a settlement building mod that you guys can download and build out yourself. You guys can expect a recap of what that livestream was all about, probably, I'd say, next week sometime, but I'm going to be doing a bit of building here on the train just because I also have a full Fallout settlement tour that's ready to go, and it's still just waiting on that green light to put it live. So until that's ready, I just want to build a bit more on the train. Now, I've covered a number of areas up so you guys can't see them. That's what these gigantic wooden walls are, because I don't want to spoil the whole settlement for you guys. There's going to be quite a lot of fun details that you guys haven't gotten to see yet. But today, I'm going to turn part of this passenger car into a dining car. And I'll show you guys how that's going to work. First of all, let me close up this door, because that's going to be an area that you won't see until the final tour. In the last update for the settlement mod, I made a number of these benches actually scrappable. It's actually called train bench, as you can see. So I'm going to scrap, I think, exactly half of these. Then from there, I want to figure out how I can fit those homemaker chairs in here. The ones that are from the diners. Let's see. Well, here, to start things off, even though I'm really starting to push my frame rate, let's place just one or two of these lights that should cast some shadows. This one? Nope, no shadows. Scrap that. Ah, this one. This is an institute light, but I think it'll actually look really, really good for the train, too. Oh, yeah, look at those awesome-looking shadows. The metal materials on the bench look almost photorealistic in this light. That is perfect. Okay, is that the center, though? Well, I guess it's going to have to be, because that light is glitched into the ceiling and I can't grab it for now. Let's place one more, perhaps, in the end car. Where could it go? Like this, maybe? I don't like that shadow, actually. That casts an even more awkward shadow. Okay. Well, I'm going to stop wasting copper at this point. Let's just place one more of these. Don't know if you guys can hear it, but my video card is absolutely humming with all these lights. That's what I'm going to have to watch for as the settlement gets closer to completion. If I want to keep building stuff, I've really got to be careful how many of these shadow casting lights I place. But I think, especially in the train cars, they just add a lot of character. Okay, furniture, seats, benches would make a lot more sense. Sure enough, there we go. I have the full-size ones here with the table. Oh yeah, if we just put them to one side, they are going to work great. I'll start with one back here. Let's get it lined up nicely. I'm really happy with how these protective additions on the outside of the train were added in the creation kit. These bits of plywood and board makes it look like a nice train, you know, one that you'd be happy to ride in the apocalypse, but also one that does fit in the apocalypse. It is battle ready. You guys can see here I've got some of these sliding doors that work as firing ports. You can open and close them. Again, those shadows just look awesome. So almost like an actual train diner, or perhaps the food prep areas on an airplane, we're going to have a food prep area in the back of the train as well. First, I want to see, are there any good cabinets that would really fit in for in here? As far as food prep stations go. If we glitch this one into the wall just a bit, it could be part of the food prep station. And that'll leave room for some storage back here. Just gonna check through a couple of areas. This cabinet, which I don't use very often, after being resized a tiny bit, makes a great addition to the back of seat here. Just make sure it's not poking through at all. Make it look like it's more shallow than it actually is. There was that one diner counter could possibly work really, really nicely along this wall. Yeah, this one right here. But is it too damaged? Like, it's really, really worn down. This shop counter right here, if it weren't so deep, would be a great fit. I can always just use these pieces. Before I commit, let's go back to that initial diner counter. Because the inside of the train is worn, but I don't know if it's worn enough to justify, like, that worn down of a texture. But then I think this one's too pristine. Like, look at that wood, it's perfect. And there is some damage on these seats, on the texture, so yeah. I think that counter does not fit in very well at all. So back we go. Now this diner is definitely too damaged, but this countertop right here, that looks good. We can just glitch that into the floor a bit. Just run some shop counter down the side here. I don't think it snaps though. Oh, that sucks. Okay. Give me a second, guys. Let me just align this by hand. So this will just give us some extra visual interest. So the purpose of this car is to transport citizens of the Commonwealth who have purchased a ticket in somewhat style across the Commonwealth. It's going to be a nice stateroom behind me here at the end of the hallway. And then you can also get a snack and hopefully not get blown up as you travel across the Commonwealth. I think these papers are floating just a tiny bit. There we go. And we'll disable and enable to get rid of that flicker glitch. You can really see when things float when there's a shadow casting light above them. So I think this is a cool use of the space where you've got some of the normal train benches, but also the dining area. I think that just really makes things look cool. It's a very cozy feeling car already. So let's keep going with some of the surfaces. I want to figure out what we can do for containers. Because there has to be some food storage in the back here, and I think this locker is a perfect fit. If only I had a mini fridge as well. So we've got some food storage there. That's our emergency access ladder. Could I actually make a mini fridge, I wonder? I'm curious now. I have to see what we could build as far as fixtures go. Jukebox, water fountain. Oh yeah, guys, there's no bathroom on this train. Now that's an interesting problem that I could look into solving. So instead of a luxurious stateroom, what if this was the bathroom? That might even make more sense, guys. Tell you what, I'm gonna store these furniture items, and I'll give you guys a hint here. I'll leave the rug. No, I'll go ahead and put that away too. There's going to be a special car that handles the luxury side of things. That's all I'm gonna say. But basically, this luxury cabin is not a requirement for the train. Again, I have another car that has that covered. And really thinking about it, I don't believe we have any parts of this train that have bathrooms at all. And even though there's no real way to travel in between cars, it might make sense to have a traveling bathroom on. So I think I should scrap the stateroom idea on this car, and because it is the dining car and also has some public transportation, I think having some bathrooms here would make a lot more sense. You guys tell me what you think. Of course, I'm going to have to size all of these manually. These bathroom stalls. I don't think, guys, we can use the actual swinging stall doors just because we have such small amounts of space to work with here. So I'm going to have a curtain system with one toilet and one urinal. I think that makes the most sense. How tall is this cubicle? The stall wall. There we go. I'll put a light bulb in the back corner there. But again, this is the fun part about doing builds with you guys, is I get to hear some feedback. So just to reiterate, seeing I do have a luxury car that's being taken care of elsewhere, what do you guys think about this bathroom idea here? And I'll do an institute-style sink, which looks a little bit too clean and modern, but also has that streamlined look that would make a lot of sense for a sink on a train. Although I'm realizing that I put it right there where the urinal is supposed to go. So I'll shrink that down. You guys were joking last week about Bedford Station, the land of cramped spaces, these train cars are a really fun challenge to build in, even with the place everywhere tools, just because of how you have to cram everything in here. This toilet as well, I think, is a really cool looking one for a train. I think it's the Institute style. And is the urinal here? Yes, it is. It's a bit more worn down. So this is essentially a one-person bathroom, and I'm realizing there's like a crack of light right there that you can see through. I'll just scoot that over a little bit. What's a good door for the bathroom? Eh, let's hang the curtain up first, before I forget about it. Homemaker, decorations, miscellaneous, interior, and there we go. Of course, you have to have your toilet paper roll. Yeah, I'll put it on the side there. Bell for service. A notice board. I'm just going to go through all the decorations while we're here, guys. There's like nowhere this actually fits. A little bit of resizing them. It'll work. A single ceiling fan, which should be animated. Or could we do two and have some cool looking shadows? I really want to make good use of that light we've got. Yeah, the shadows are more subtle than I expected. That's neat though. I want the bulletin board, but I also want that clock. So I'm gonna put some posters on this, so I'll just cover up a window for now. After all, they're already boarded up on the outside. Anyway, give it one resize on the clock. Ah, that lighting just looks so cool. I love it. And there's the curtain for the bathroom stall. A do-it-yourself shelf there. I'll just hang the curtain from the ceiling. I normally have like a runner that the curtains are hanging from, but I've got to draw the line on detail somewhere because I still have quite a few areas I want to detail in this settlement. Okay, so we have the urinal. We have the stall. Still a one-person bathroom. Any other indoor accessories for the bathroom? Oh, a mirror. It's the smallest one that we have. This one's pretty tiny. That's perfect. Awesome. Dirty, but perfect. We can even have a newspaper rack for those that are riding the train. They can read public occurrences and whatnot. Glitch it back into the wall just so it's flat. You know, the shower curtain here I think has a better looking color than the living room curtains. Yeah, definitely. Because the train has a slightly Vault-Tec look to it. Especially in this Vault-Tec passenger car. Surprise, surprise. Now, if you guys have been here for a while, you'll know that I don't detail everything on these Let's Build videos because there will be a final tour with my good friend Joel. I like to save some surprises, even on the areas that I've worked on with you guys, for that final tour. So I'm going to resist the urge to go through every single one of these detail props. And I'm going to finish the bathroom for now by putting a door on it. I will come back to it on my own to add those last few touches. I think the closet door is a good fit for the bathroom. So now we've got our writing area and our dining area. Feels quite cozy. Some nice lighting and animation going. I want to go back to... where was it? Furniture. Surfaces. Counters and cabinets. Just for a minute. Because I feel like... we can do a few more things with... these spaces like that. After all, that's supposed to be our food prep area with a small oven, probably a heating, what is it called? Not a space heater. Wow, the cooking hot plate. There we go. Wow, it is late. Brain is dead. A hot plate on top, most likely. Can also fit a couple of these shelves that were built into the train just like that. That looks really cool. And it even matches the wood back here with that table. And of course the same shop counter pieces there. And yes, I see that that paper's floating. I'll fix it later. So food storage. Extra prep area and food storage. Gonna add one more counter piece to here. This works quite well. Make it almost built in looking. So when the train is in motion, okay, gotta have a seat for the, not flight attendant, but train attendant. What would they be called? Having a second mind blank now. What kind of chair would they have back here? Perhaps just one of those vault chairs. Though I feel like they would have a chair that's kind of, you know, solid and would not go anywhere. But also wouldn't block that emergency hydraulic lock right there. Benches. I don't think any of these really fit. Maybe just a simple stool, actually. Let's do a save before I forget about it. So just to finish off for tonight, guys, because after all, this was supposed to be a slightly shorter Let's Build episode, I'll give you guys an idea of some of the detail that I might be adding in before I call it complete over here. For example, in the kitchen area, I had mentioned a hot plate. So let's see if Creative Clutter has any good hot plates. I got the food shelf. Some food. If I'm looking specifically for this right here. Just a way to make some simple food on the train. How exclusive would this be? You're on a apocalyptic train that's covered in cannons and turrets. You've also got some old world, not style, but comforts, really. And then there would be some things like this tea set. Although it would probably be on the tray. And perhaps someone eating their TV dinner on the train. That's where I'm going to stop on the micro detailing. I'll save the rest of it for the final tour, but that is looking so atmospheric. I love it. What I don't love is this paper, which is really starting to annoy me. Okay, and then disable, and then enable. There we go. No more crazy shadows below it. I am remembering I did forget one thing from under Homemaker. That's going to be furniture, fixtures. I forgot to make our mini fridge. Is it under containers? Home? That's a washer. It could pass for a fridge, though. If I take this new style teal fridge and just shrink it down, how does that look? Okay, that's too cool. It's a mini fridge. Perfect for the train. Although you might have to use the stool to get to it. Oh, and of course, just for my immersion, got to have the curtains to divide the food prep area from the seating area. Very important. Now it feels like an airplane. Okay, guys. We're going to stop there for tonight. Hope you've enjoyed this mini Let's Build episode as we worked on our dining car. Thanks for watching, guys. And I'll see you all next time.